everyone example first. Draw factor tree of 48. Example first. Draw factor tree of 48. Draw factor tree of 48. Listen carefully, students. If I want to draw factor tree of any number, firstly, I want to divide by least number. If you want to draw any factor tree, you can divide by least number. Now, digit is what here? 48. Now, 48, I want to divide by least number. Then, least number firstly is 2. Now, if I am dividing 48 by 2, listen carefully, everyone. Stop writing. Now, 48 divided by 48 divided by 2. 2 twos are 4, 2 fours are 8, right? Next, again 24 divided by least number. Students, if how you will check this number divisible by 2, 3, 4? Already I have given divisibility rule concept to you. Now 24, once place digit is 4, then we can say yes, this number divisible by 2. Then I have divided by 2, this answer has come. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 12. Again 12, I want to check, 12 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, because 2 is present on ones place. Again divided by 2, then this answer will become 6. Again 6 I want to divide by, again 6 I want to divide by least number. Then 6 I have divided by least number, 2, then answer has come 3. Now this is not final answer. Final answer is what? Final answer is 48 is equal to how many 2 times? 1, 2, 3, 4 times. This is final answer. After drawing factor tree, students, you need to write that factor of the digit. Draw everyone firstly. Second example, draw factor tree of, example second, draw factor tree of 120. All students, start drawing along with me. Solution. First digit is 120. 120, I want to check. This digit is divisible by 2 or not? Yes. Why? Because once a place digit is 0, then I'm dividing by 2. then 2 6s are 12, 60 will be answer. Again I want to check, 60 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, because ones place digit is 0. Then I will divide by 2. Now 60 divided by 2, answer has come 30. Again 30 I want to check, 30 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, because ones place digit is 0. Very good. Next, 2, 15. Again I want to check, 15 is divisible by 2 or not? No. Why? Because ones place digit is 5. If ones place digit is 5, that number is not divisible by 2. Now I want to check, this digit is divisible by 3 or not? I want to check how to check. A number is divisible by 3, the sum of all digits will be divisible by 3. 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. Now 6 is coming 3 table. Then we can divide by 3. 3 5s are 15. Then I will write here, 120 is equal to 2 3 times 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Everyone take fresh space. On the top key heading, chapter 3. Chapter 3, simplification. Chapter 3, simplification. Chapter 3, simplification. Chapter 3, simplification. Now tell me students, what is the meaning of simplification? Always we are using one word, simplification, simplify, simplify. What is the meaning of simplification? What is the meaning of simplification? Simplification is nothing but, it is the process of making something simpler. It is the process of making something simpler or something easier. What is simplification? Simplification is the process of making something simpler or something easier. Understood everyone? What is the meaning of simplification? Simplification is the process of making something simpler or easier. Now left side key fading, simplification. Key fading left side everyone, simplification. Key fading, simplification. The process of making something simpler or easier to do or understand, If anyone is asking what is the meaning of simplification, you can simply say It is the process of making something simpler or easier. Now, students, in this chapter, we are going to learn about addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Means the properties of addition, properties of subtraction, properties of multiplication, and properties of division. Now, keep reading first. Properties of addition and subtraction. Keep reading. Properties of addition and subtraction. Left side, keep reading. Properties of addition and subtraction. Properties of addition and subtraction. Defining properties of addition and subtraction. Student, listen carefully. Already this all property we have learned in the first chapter. Closure property, commutative property, associative property, distributive property, additive identity, multiplicative identity. This all property we have learned in the previous chapter, okay? In first chapter. Again, we are going to learn this property, but with the help of symbols, plus sign, minus sign, into and division sign, right? Yeah, students, some question I want to ask to you. One question I want to ask you. Yes. Right. Yeah. First property is what? Closure property. Don't try, listen carefully. Closure property. This property is saying if A, comma B and C or any three numbers, then A plus B is equal to C. A minus B is equal to C. Listen carefully. What is this property? This property is saying if there are three numbers, we are doing addition operation. Suppose 3 plus 5. 3 is number, 5 is number, 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 8 is also number. Then we can apply. Closure property in the case of addition and subtraction. I am doing, listen, 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. 5 is number, 3 is number, 2 is also number. Means closure property we can apply in the case of addition and subtraction. Note down, everyone.